One, the activity and the characteristics of demons. As you look at Mark chapter 5, you have this man. In verse 2, it says he was in the tomb. He will not stay in the house. The devil drove him to a place of darkness, a place of departed spirits. And it says in the latter part of verse 2, he had an unclean spirit. In verse 3, it says he was dwelling among the tombs. He was separated from society. He will not fit into society because the demons have made him not to be compatible with society. Are there people like that? They cannot stay quietly in the midst of other people. Either they are shouting, or they're screaming, or they're crying, or they're enjoying themselves because they cannot live at peace in the community of people. Not only that, he had a kind of extra-human power. They bound him with fetters, and they bound him with chains, and it was like nothing could bind him. He broke the chains in pieces. Now, you understand, there are people like that. They have a problem that you try to help, and you try to bind, and you try to make them keep quiet. They cannot. An evil spirit, a demon, has taken over their lives. In the latter part of verse 4, it says, and neither could any man tame him. Have you noticed people that they're beyond themselves and they want to control themselves? They cannot. Other people want to tame them. They cannot. Other people want to bring them quiet. They cannot, because another power is working in their lives. And they are the people that will say, you know, I'd like to be quiet, but I couldn't. I like to stay calm, but I couldn't, because nothing and nobody could tame them. And always night and day, in verse 5, he was in the mountains. He was jobless. He had thrown away profession. He had taken to the mountains. And he was like that, crying and cutting himself. He was feeling the pain. That's why he was crying. And yet, all the crying and all the pain could not stop him. He was still hurting himself and cutting himself with stones. And when he saw Jesus, he ran to worship him. But then the next verse says, he cried out and says, what have I to do with you, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High? Have you seen, you know, those two have double personalities. On the one hand, they are running to Jesus as if they want something from Jesus. When they get to Jesus, then they're saying, what have I to do with you? Get away from me. It was not the man, it was the evil spirit. You know, sometimes you find people like that. They want to do good, and they come to church, and they come, they say they are coming to Christ, and they're even running. I must not miss anything in the service. And now they come to the service, they turn to be another person. And then they'll be crying out, we don't want that. We don't want Bible. We don't want the teaching of the Word of God. But you are the one running and you are coming. And now that you have come, you turn to be another man. Split personality. And Jesus said, come out of him. Whatever personality is driving anyone, distracting anyone, it will come out tonight in Jesus' name. Mark chapter 9. I'm reading from verse 17. Mark chapter 9, verse 17. The activity and the characteristics of demons. And one of the multitude answered and said, Master, I have brought unto thee my son, which has a dumb spirit. And wheresoever he taketh him, he teareth him, and foameth, and gash and gnasheth with his teeth, and pineth away. And I speak to the disciples that they should cast him out, and he could not. See, this one, it wasn't like the other man were, because the characteristics of demons vary from person to person. This one will foam in the mouth. and this one would gnash with the teeth and caught his own tongue with his teeth, and then he's pining away, he's dying away, and sometimes he'll fall into the water and sometimes into the fire. And Jesus, he answered him saying, O faithless generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer you? Bring him unto me. And he brought him unto him. And when he saw him, straightway the spirit cheered him. And he began to tear himself, but people will not understand. It's the evil spirit. When you find people like that, tearing themselves, destroying themselves, cutting themselves, doing evil to themselves, it's not them, it's the evil spirit. And he fell to the ground and wallowed for me. And he asked his father, how long is it ago since this came upon him? And he said, of a child, and oftentimes it has cast him into the fire and into the waters to destroy him. But if thou canst do anything, have compassion on us, on him, on me, on the mother, on the family, and help us. Jesus says unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. Tonight, all things are possible to everyone who believes in Jesus' name. Luke chapter 8, the activity and the characteristics of demons. Luke chapter 8, verse 29. In verse 29, for he had commanded the unclean spirit to come out of the man, for oftentimes it had caught him. And he was kept bound in chains, or chains, and in fetters, and he broke the bands, and was driven of the devil into the desert. Driven of the devil, running when there was nobody chasing him. He had seen an evil personality, evil power, and now he's running and running to the wilderness. But Jesus will solve the problem, and Jesus will solve our problems, and Jesus will solve my problem. He will, in Jesus'